300 mm diameter in butterfly shape, anatomic silicone grips, two rotary encoders, 10 illuminated buttons with 8 different colors, 3 rotary encoders, 2 joysticks, magnetic shifters, dual shifter, LED ref indicator, quick release system. I guess just another GT wheel on the market. What makes it so different? $259. That's what makes it interesting. Well, that's another community request product, and in my opinion, Moza hit the 10-point mark. This is direct competitor to the all-time favorite GT3 McLaren from Fanatec, which has 1,000 inputs for the price of $200. And in fact, I love that wheel so much, and I spent on top another €370 to upgrade and make it compatible with all my bases. The question is how the KS compares to the McLaren, which I transform into Porsche anyway with my Race Beyond Mother logo. Besides the aesthetics, which is totally subjective matter, the Moza is better in almost every possible way. The body of the KS is made of carbon reinforced polymer, which gives nice premium look and have zero flex. And I mean zero flex. No squishy sound forcing the handles, nothing. I'm not saying the McLaren have some crazy flex, but forcing the handles make a little squishy noise. And I'm curious to see how will that perform with the time, but for now it's absolutely silent. The grips and touch in both wheels feels identical with very similar thickness, just the anatomics are a bit different, but from comfort point of view, I like them both, so I will call them even here. Ergonomically, within thumb reach without removing hands off the grips, with the KS I have access to 11 inputs comfortably on each side versus 4 on the McLaren. The push buttons on the KS have the feeling of €1,500 wheel I have here, which is insane. Short press with very clear feedback. Require almost double the torque from those on the McLaren. I love the switches on the Fanatec, but thumb rotaries are definitely better choice, and those here with that shape and stiffness feels really premium in operation. Two rotaries on the Fanatec, and this here is just to switch between different modes. Three rotaries on the KS, and both wheels are very similar in operation and precision, just one extra on the Moza. The McLaren have one 7-way funky switch, which every sim racer love, and on the Moza we have two joysticks, which can be mapped in the pit house as buttons too. I would personally switch the two joysticks for one 7-way funky switch, and that's the only reason I've said the KS is almost better in every possible way. Fanatec display can show gear, speed or RPMs, but the KS have rev lights, and both indicators are important to me, so I will call them even here too. The original shifters from the McLaren were something I didn't like at all, so I paid €150 for those from Sim Racing Machine, which also make the wheel look really premium. But even those doesn't feel much better than the ones on the Moza. Also, those are contactless and must last forever. Clear win for the KS. The dual clutch system on the McLaren have a little bit more tension and travel, but those handles are plastic, those are aluminium, and I personally don't care much about that system. I use those pedals mostly for brake adjustments, and I will call them even here. The quick release on the Moza is also one of the best, and on Fanatec, one of the worst, so there is no question who is the winner here. So, if we use their native ecosystem and add the good quick release to the McLaren in price, they will be in the same range, but the KS will be definitely better wheel. And what I like about Moza is they're open for other ecosystems with the universal hub kit and base adapter for $65. This can be used with other bases through USB with full access to the wheel telemetry, color adjustment, and different mods. With the McLaren, things are going out of control using third-party adapter and different quick release. As I've said, I spent over 300 euro to be able to use it with my other bases and lost the dual clutch system. I still love the McLaren, but it looks like we have new winner in that price range. However, there is one thing I will criticize Moza, but that can be just personal preference, and in this one, I gonna need your help. I drive sim almost every day for more than 20 years, and in the last 10, I use 7-way HUD switches to navigate the black box and menu under intense driving. This is something my brain hardwired, and I definitely avoid using those joysticks under intense driving because I just can't be precise. I know Moza team are listening in the community, and I would personally love to see what is your opinion about that, because my personal opinion doesn't really matter. Are you happy with the joystick buttons, or you prefer 7-way funky switches? Let your honest opinion and totally ignore my personal preferences. I know Moza are checking the comment section and they care what you think, not me. Other than that, in my personal opinion, with that price, the KS is quite an achievement. Premium quick release with super sturdy body with plastic knobs, but with very positive feedback in use rotary encoders. Beautiful push buttons, illuminated with 8 different nice choice of colors, and really, really good feedback. Rev light fully synchronized with each car and choice of colors. Magnetic shifters, dual clutch, definitely the new boss in that price range. Well then, Moza, you complete another community request. I can really see many people happy with this beauty.